हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड हेल्दी। स्टूडेंट्स, यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट द स्टोरी ऑफ टू क्वारलिंग कैट्स एंड अ मंकी इन योर चाइल्डहुड। वेल, इफ यू हैव नेवर हर्ड अबाउट इट, लेट मी गिव यू एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ दैट स्टोरी। In that story, there were two cats who were fighting for a piece of cake. Watching the fight of these two cats, the third party, that is the monkey, took advantage of it and finally ate whole cake and went away. So this was the overview of that story. But why am I telling you this story, students? It is because the Britishers also had expanded their empire in India with such a policy, and with this, by the mid of 18th century, the Britishers had started to emerge as a strong power on the Indian political horizon. Also, to serve their economic interest, they increased their political hold on India with the use of British diplomatic tactics. Students, one of that tactics was Wellesley's policy of expansion. Well, students, when Wellesley came to India as the Governor General, there was a cutthroat competition. That means there was a fierce and intense competition between England and France. Well, in order to check France from becoming powerful in India and to expand the British rule in India, Wellesley introduced subsidiary alliance system. Well, now let us discuss some of the terms and conditions of this plan, that is subsidiary alliance system. Well, according to this system, if a state accepts the system, then the army trained by the East India Company will be provided to the state. In return, the state accepting the system will provide the army or give away provinces with equivalent income to the Britishers. That means you have to provide food, shelter and money to the army for their services, and if you are unable to pay, then you have to give away provinces which is equivalent to that income. Well, moving to third condition is, without the permission of the company, the state will not wage war or sign any treaty with other state. That means you cannot fight with other state without the permission of the Britishers. And also you can't sign any agreement with other states. The fourth condition says that there will be one English representative in the state assembly. Whenever there is a state assembly, there will be one English representative present in that assembly where the discussion is going on. And the fifth condition is, students, that is, you cannot employ other foreigners in the state other than Britishers. Only the Britishers will be employed in the state. No other foreigners will be employed in the state. Hope you have understood the terms and conditions of the subsidiary alliance system. Now let us move to next topic. The topic is consequences of the subsidiary alliance system. Consequences means the result of the subsidiary alliance system. Well, by this system, the British could maintain their army without spending any money, because who will provide them food, shelter and all that? State will provide, right? So they don't have to spend any money. Second thing, this system, which made many feel secure in the beginning, at the beginning when the state signed the system, they feel like Britishers are their friend. But eventually they came to understand that this system was like enslaving, and that is threatened with the passage of time. It is threatening with the passage of time. The subsidiary alliance system students acted like a slow poison for the princely state. Well, because of this subsidiary alliance system, the Indian states became victim of this system, where Hyderabad, Mysore, Ayodhya, Jodhpur, Gaikwads of Vadodara, Peshwas of Pune and Sindhias of Gwalior. Now moving to next topic, that is how different states became victim of subsidiary alliance system. Right now I have told you some of the states became victim of subsidiary alliance system, and here we will discuss how they became victim of the subsidiary alliance system. So the first is because of the losses incurred by Nizam in the fight with Marathas, he was the first to accept the subsidiary alliance system. Students, Nizam had took loans from Britishers to fight with Marathas, in which he incurred many losses, and because of which he was the first to accept the subsidiary alliance system. On the other hand, Tipu Sultan of Mysore refused to accept this system, because of which Britishers along with Nizam fought Fourth Mysore, Anglo-Mysore War, in which Tipu Sultan was defeated and Mysore was forced to sign the subsidiary alliance system. This is how Mysore also became victim of the subsidiary alliance system. While Maratha chief fought amongst themselves like the cats I have discussed before, after the death of Nana Phadnavis. And because of this, one by one, all Maratha states became victim of divide and rule policy of the Britishers. Also, the other states, namely Ayodhya, Gorakhpur, Tanjore, Farukabad, Karnataka, also suffered the same way as others were suffered. In this way, within a span of 7 years, Wellesley expanded the East India Company rule and made the British supreme in India. Well, for today, there was this much only. We will meet with a new topic in a new lecture. Till then, take care of yourself, stay home, stay safe. Bye bye.